1937, King Island, Alaska. A primitive place inhabited by a handful of Eskimos. Father Hubbard settled down to live among them and learn their folk ways. He had a theory that all Eskimos have a common origin in Asia. To test it, he planned a 1,000-mile boat voyage along the shore of the Bering Sea. He would visit the Eskimo settlements along the shore to learn if they all spoke the same language and followed the same customs. His goal? Point Lay. Although far from King Island, the natives of Point Lay spoke the same language and followed the same folkways. That was true of all the other settlements. Proof that Father Hubbard's theory was correct. Satisfied with the results of his voyage, he started back to King Island. Winter was setting in as he reached King Island. For 9 months, there would be no contact with the mainland. But those months went pleasantly. The Eskimos were simple but hospitable. Outdoors, the winter storms raged across the island. But in their huts, the Eskimos amused themselves and Father Hubbard with ancient dances and ceremonials. The winter passed quickly. With the coming of spring, Father Hubbard saw the frozen earth thaw rapidly and bear fruit, flowers growing where snow had piled high before. Father Hubbard went up on the mountain crags and watched the boys as they gathered bird eggs. He went out with the Eskimo fishermen. He saw that Alaska provides a good life for its people. As his boat carried Father Hubbard to the mainland, a new project was born. He would go on a lecture tour to break down the notion that Alaska was a frozen wilderness. He would spread word of the opportunities that awaited settlers in the north. The project succeeded. Years later, Father Hubbard visited the new Alaskan settlers. He saw kids playing in modern grounds like kids in any other part of America. The new farmers had flocks of sheep and goats, herds of cows, fresh milk for children in the far north. The Alaskan farmers cultivated their land with modern equipment. They grew every sort of crop in earth that was once thought of as wasteland. Potatoes of record-breaking size. He had been right. Alaska was a bountiful land. That farmer harvesting his celery? He might have been a clerk in the big city. Here he was a king. All this Father Hubbard had helped to make possible by his scientific explorations in the north and by his lecture tours. The man of God had earned the name given to him by his Eskimo friends, a tetapak, which means Big Father.